Hello friends!
Hi!
We are off to search for wintergreen and to share with you a little bit about it.
Going to Wintergreen Ridge. We haven't been there for over a year. We can't wait to share it with you.
What are you finding here?
First, twin berry. It's not a wintergreen berry.
Oh yeah, how do you tell? That's not a wintergreen
berry. It's two dots.
The two dots, okay. Can you eat that?
Yes.
Another one.
Oh, I want it.
Are they good?
Well, I'm not sure. I haven't had it yet. They are. Purple. Hi, Patty. And white.
Wow, beautiful. Like most wild places, once you get over the hill, back, hidden with some trees between you and the path, you're pretty much on your own. We've been watching the shadows as we walk. This today we're going almost horizontal with them. Then we know that we're on the right path. And if you keep yourself lined up with the shadows, then in general, you're gonna know which direction you're going. You can keep yourself on a pretty straight line. If I find that I've turned and I'm going parallel with the shadows this way, or that I'm walking at an angle with them this way, I know, oh, wait a second, I have lost my direction. Of course, that's gonna change throughout the day, but we just keep an idea in our head that those are gonna shift slightly and know which direction they're gonna go according to the sun. And then when we know that something's in, say, straight to the north, like we're going today, we can keep on a pretty good straight path. There are some paths through these woods, and that's where people sometimes walk. But take a look at this. But we were just looking down at the leaves, and you might be able to see some of the disturbance where the girls and Rebecca just walked. But we're noticing that the leaves are pretty intact. You can look over at leaves on the side of the path and you can compare. You can get an idea of how much travel has been going on this path. If people were walking on it a lot, it's going to slowly get smushed and shredded and look more like that. But you can see in general, people haven't been walking on this path very much this year yet. It's still early spring, but all right, what have you found, Liliana?
I have found wintergreen. You can tell that we're here.
Yeah.
Here's our stem.
Okay.
And here's our leaf.
How can you tell it's wintergreen?
It's bigger than twin berries. This is twin berry. And this is wintergreen.
I see the difference.
And also, this one's a little lighter green than this one.
Uh-huh.
This one's got smaller leaves.
That distinct,
not as pointy as
mid-rib,
these.
Don't they? That white.
And they don't have as smooth as wintergreen.
Yeah. And what else about it?
Well, it usually has 3 leaves or 4 leaves, but it can sometimes have this.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I see 3, 4. What do the leaves feel like?
They're very slippery.
They're slippery?
They're also shiny.
Kind of waxy and shiny. Yeah, let's have a look. Yeah.
They also have that like detailed little things.
And what about the flavor?
It's minty.
Yeah? Pretty strong, right?
Mm-hmm. The berries are edible too. I think this is also one, but young.
Yeah, look at that.
It's red.
These beautiful little green leaves have something called methyl salicylate in them, which is really, really, really similar to what's found in aspirin. And so this can be used in the same way that you would for pain relief and anti-inflammation. However, it's very, very potent, not to be used for kids, and it can damage the liver and the kidneys. So I'd probably stick to just nibbling it on the trail. Maybe making a tea once in a while. I know that the oil is sometimes used if you have a chest cold, or I think it's even in some things like tiger balm where it would relieve muscle pain.
Bengay.
Bengay.
Yep.
Bengay. Secret ingredient, wintergreen. Again, very useful, but on a regular basis, just like Christmas. Tastes like Christmas time.
Mm-hmm. It's like candy. Actually, sometimes we should pick a few and make candy. Put them in.
Good tea, doesn't it? That's a good tea.
Wouldn't that be so good?
These Northwood lakes embody the word pristine for me. No houses along them, no people. Just water and woods. Loon, swan, Canada goose. You can swim on a full moon night, and it's just you and the stars. Oh, what did we bring?
Or dandelion jello. I don't know how to pronounce the actual name.
Oh, so pretty. What does it taste like, Liliana? Liquid sunshine? Why is it, girls?
What?
Well, we made these kind of special natural brownies the other day, and we didn't really like them when we were eating them in the house, but out here they taste great. Why does everything taste better in nature?
I don't know.
I wonder if it's because you taste things more, or you have more awareness of their texture and their flavor, because you're already in that mindset. When you're out in nature, at least for me, I like to look at the texture of the lichen and the bark, and listen to that bird song and the wind, the smells that are around of the pine needles, and I'm already really in my senses. And then I wonder if you throw something in there that normally you just eat an orange, that it becomes, oh, look at the skin and smell the oils and the color, and it all just is more real.
What are you doing?
I put swinberry inside.
Oh my gosh. That is so cool. Yum. I suppose you could put wintergreen in there and have chocolate mint.
Oh yeah. I put wintergreen leaves though.
I have a sliver that's sticking straight out of my finger, and Mirabelle is going to show us how to get it out using
a knife.
You can see that little sliver there, probably. So she's going to take the knife.
I'm going to hold it at a 90 and
slide it across. Wah, sliver is gone. And we're not seeing it on the edge there. Usually you can see it on the edge there.
We're gonna try wintergreen berries. They have these really cool little petal thingies. On bigger ones, they're even more like a star than this one. There's got little one wisp, one hair.
Okay.
It's gonna be ready? One hair. Ready? On it. They taste like the wintergreen leaf, but sweeter.
Really? What do you think?
I love them. Good. So good. Yeah, I think I got. Let's go find more. Come on.
That's an aspen. Isn't that crazy? The bark at the bottom looks almost like a white pine or oak.